98online.com/livewire.
Michelle, you cool mind beans. If I throw a jam your way?
What jam are you throwing?
Because you know I'm all about that bass.
That's my kid's song. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. We got the guy on the phone, the guy who wrote it.
You're kidding me, Scott.
Yeah, he's a friend of the, he's part, he's family.
Someone wrote
he's,
that.
He's like a second family to us here.
Awesome.
Darren Kadish. Yeah. Member of Kadish, Kadish, and Kadish, 98 Rock Attorney General. He's our lawyer when we have anything questionable we want to do that could get us in trouble. We talk to him. His brother, Kevin Kadish,
wrote that?
Wrote this song.
Are you kidding me?
Number one pop song in the world. Number one in
Yikes.
Like a ton of countries.
Yikes.
Joining us on the phone, Kevin Kadish. Hello. Good morning.
Kadish. Hey. Good morning, Kevin Kadish. I'm excited to meet you.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing this morning, bud?
How's life when you open your eyes every morning now?
And it's all about that bass.
Mm-hmm. I mean, holy cow, man.
Is it just
incredible?
Is it different now?
You know, I'm still working every day, still trying to make music.
Yeah, but just knowing that it's out there and it's going into all those ear holes and it's people are loving it and it's blowing up. I mean, you've been at the game a long time and finally it's like this is one of the biggest thing ever, right?
Bro, it's super humbling. I mean, I've had hits before and I've had songs on the radio before, but nothing as a global number one. It's insane.
Okay, I need you in my life. I need you to do a global something for me. I need you in my life,
right, that's
Kadish.
What we want.
I just want to say your last name over and over again. Kadish, Kadish, Kadish.
It sounds like a vegetable you've never heard of.
It sounds like something that's good for you, but you don't want to eat it.
Yeah. Eat your Kadish.
Yeah, like I have a steak with a side of Kadish.
Yes.
So
yes.
Explain to me, Kevin Kadish, we talked to your brother yesterday, and he kind of threw out some round figures and stuff as far as the royalties you'll get for this.
He seems very jealous.
He's super, by the way,
jealous.
He's riddled with jealousy.
Riddled.
Riddled with
he's
jealousy.
He's got to wear a suit every day and go to work as a lawyer. Kevin's out in L.A. just, you know, living the dream.
I just left L.A., Kevin. We should have got together. What's the deal?
I'm actually in Nashville, man. I live here now.
Oh, you are? Okay.
Music hotspot. Yeah. Are you going to live off this song? Could this song financially prop you up for
forever.
A year, two years, or the rest of your life?
How many copies have you bought?
That's a good
We do work at a rock station.
That's a good point.
I'm going to direct you to a fellow by the name of Kane.
You know what? It's been a blessing to my family, and it's pretty incredible that it's happened, and hopefully it continues to happen. You know, her next single that I wrote and produced is doing really well. It's number 29 after on pop radio after.
So you're part of the follow-up single, too?
I produced the whole record. I produced 10 songs on the record.
You are
guy.
A bucket
that's
of awesome
so cool.
is what you are.
Truly is.
A bucket of
and
awesome.
And it's like Darren said, you know what? The record industry is different nowadays with digital downloads and people just pirating stuff. So it's hard to really, really make money. But he said, you know, the ripple effect from something like this where your phone will start to ring and, hey, you know, he's the guy behind this song. Oh, he is? Well, let's call him up. Let's get him to do some stuff for us. You're going to be all right.
Honestly, that's the biggest windfall from this whole thing is getting the calls that I've been getting and getting into rooms. So, I mean, it's incredible, bro. I mean, incredible.
You sound so
and
humble.
I've done a lot in my career. I mean, it only took me, 15, 20 years to be an overnight success. So.
Yeah, you've been doing it a long, long time, and you got some great credits.
Again, Kevin Kadish, he wrote All About That Bass.
Because you know I'm all about that bass.
Joins us on the phone. How do you write
where'd it come from?
Song called All About That Bass, no treble? Are you, Kevin, are you all about that bass, no treble? You turn the treble all the way to negative 10?
Well, I had the title for a while. You know, like, that title was, I keep a list of titles. When I'm driving in the car, I'll think of something. I think, oh, that could be a good song.
You answered a question I've always had. Have people, I swear to God, there are movies, books, and songs where they come up with a title and then they're like, man, how clever. Let me now write something beneath that. So you have a whole book of song titles with no actual songs.
Right.
Hot damn it, I knew it.
So you were driving one day, and then All About That Bass came down. You wrote it down, but then how does it come to fruition?
Well, I met Megan Trainor. She was just a 19-year-old songwriter at the time. She wasn't even trying to be an artist. And we met through a mutual friend. And beyond that, like the first day we met, we wrote All About That Bass. That was the first day we ever met.
That's so weird. And how long did it take to like write and produce?
To write maybe an hour or two.
Isn't that amazing?
Maybe.
To do
the track maybe a day or two.
A few hours slash days out of your life, which will be, you know, a 70-year life. 2 days out of that life has now will maybe define you for forever.
Quite
it's
a long
so
time.
Amazing.
That's amazing.
You know, it's, I mean, honestly, when you think about it like that, it is incredible. I mean, 8 weeks at number one on the Hot 100.
Wow.
Yeah, dude, that's awesome.
Now you broke Michael Jackson's record as the all-time longest-running number one.
No way. No way.
Dude, the Kadish parents are definitely way more proud of you.
Yeah, way more proud.
Way more proud.
We asked Darren.
We disowned Darren.
We asked Darren yesterday who they were more proud of, and he said you. Do you believe that to be true?
No way.
Come on.
Do you have any screw-ups in the Kadish family? You've got like a you know, a successful lawyer, you got a pop song writing star, and then you got a dude who is like at a methadone clinic at 3 in the morning.
Yeah, who's Phil? Where's like
what?
Yeah, where's Phil Kadish? What I'm saying is there someone like that?
Shecky. Phil.
It's Phil.
It's Shecky.
I don't know
Shecky.
What they did, but my parents did something right. They got
There's no long lost
doctor and me.
No long lost brother named Shecky Kadish.
Shecky Kadish. Living in a train yard, hunting cats. Let me ask, is it interesting or is it difficult writing? You wrote a song for the opposite sex, or you're writing lyrics like, you know, I ain't no size two, I could shake it.
That's like not, I'm supposed
I love
to.
How you have to have some Ebonics in it for it to be pop. I ain't no size two.
I ain't no size two.
I'm trying to figure out how he's all about the bass, and he's clearly a white guy, and you don't hear rhythm or bass. So how did you do that, Kadish?
Good question.
How could you be about the bass? I want to know, can you hear the bass when you hear that song?
Because us white folks are known for our treble.
Right.
Let me ask you this. Like, if somebody writes a murder mystery, do you think they've actually murdered somebody?
You know what? Touche.
Touche.
Kadish, I am about to be a lightweight stalker of yours.
You can call
Kevin.
Him Kevin.
I'm about to be a lightweight stalker. I can't show up at your house, but I will tweet Google. I'm going to find you because that response was one of those Jeopardy answers.
That's right.
That was awesome.
Mike Anderson.
Now, Kevin, I don't know if you've heard, but we want to produce a pop song as well.
That's right.
From scratch. Do you have any tips for us? Where should we start?
Yeah.
Find something that has been said a million times, but say it a different way.
Wow.
Oh, what?
Find
now, what
something
about
that's
been
said a million times.
Like, if All About That Bass was, I like big butts and I cannot lie. You know?
Oh, is he
different way to
so
say I like big butts and I cannot lie? Hey,
see, and he just reworked it and put it back out there, and it's another smash hit.
Now, quoted Sir Mix-a-Lot. Yeah. You are amazing,
now, Kevin. What about songs?
Hey, always Mills.
What about song structure?
Song structure.
Like A, B, you know, A, C, A? Is that the typical structure?
What the hell are you talking about, Mike?
I don't know, Matt. No, he knows what he's talking about. He's talking about, like, poetry structure. Yeah, I mean, you know, there's no structure in All About That Bass, to be honest with you. It's just kind of freeform. Like, no verse is the same ever.
Huh.
The chorus is, like, sort of an anti-chorus, how it breaks down for the chorus, you know? And the biggest section of the song is a pre-chorus. How is that?
You're making it sound way more difficult. We thought this was pretty easy, dude.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think he's making it sound simple. He's like, what chorus? What the hell's an A chord?
He's like, the chorus is an anti-chorus.
Learn three chords and then talk about your life. That's all you got.
So I think what we need to do is take this guy's method of songwriting next week at some point, maybe even a hypothetical Thursday, we make it a song title first. We get the song title. And then we write a song beneath that. You listening right now, you got all weekend. Start to think of a song title. And keep in mind what Kevin said. Something that's been said a million times, but a different way to say it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm out. Are you kidding me? I'm done. Something. Spiegel! Who knows? Breaking news. Something.
Well, it's more some sort of like a thought or idea. Like he said, I like big butts. Like liking big butts. Or,
let's go with that. That's kind of cool.
Or
Rodney Mahoney. But if a girl is going to sing that, you know, like, flip it, like, I'm comfortable with my butt, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What about it? What about
true.
Scott's huge dong? What about All About That Dong? All That Dong. No
Did he
balls.
Say Scott's huge dong.
I mean, maybe you can sing that, but I would not feel comfortable. So, I don't know.
All right. Okay.
All right. Hey, Kevin Kadish, All About That Bass.
Yeah.
Good to meet you, Kevin.
All right. Hey, can
nice
we?
To meet you. Thank you so much.
Can we check in over the course of the creation of the song? Maybe get some consultation work from you free of charge?
Absolutely.
All right, yeah, very good. All right, Kevin Kadish, she wrote probably the biggest song on the planet right now.
I ain't no size two, but I can shake it like I'm supposed to. StudyItOnline.com.